Hi, I'm Christophe. We are here at the Embedded World 2020 and I'm an engineer at Fitech France. I'm working as a hardware and software developer. I'm doing also some technical support and I was in charge of developing this carrier board for the new FireCore STM32MP1. It's a result of a partnership with STMicroelectronics. And this new processor has a microcontroller unit, M4, and a microprocessor unit Cortex based on Cortex A7. So.
And it also has a M4 in there, right?
Yeah, it has an M4, of course. And what we want to show you is that it's a really interesting product when we want to do real-time application, but also graphical. So here it's a demo with our brand new kit. We've got the SOM here based on the STM32MP1. And I can show you how the demo works. So we have a graphic running on Linux. We can control the motor here. So the motor starts. And the motor control part is running on the M4 MCU, so it's a real-time application, and the graphic is running on Linux, so with the Cortex A7 motor processor unit.
So this is a full Linux over there?
This is a full Linux. Here we have what we call a stroboscope, so we can measure the speed, which is here, and we see the motor is stable because the pattern, the three black patterns are not moving. So graphical allows to do all the control stuff with the human interface machine. All the values come from the M4 firmware running. So real-time application is good for the M4.
This is a very unique solution?
No.
STM32MP1 and also...
Yes, competitors, but this one has an ecosystem from STM32MP, which is really interesting. For reusing codes, existing code. So for clients who already know the STM32, that's really easy to use this new brand processor.
And what's the advantage of working with Fitech on doing this? Are you able to do some custom implementations?
So the advantage is, of course, the sum to do a new design from this sum, and also we provide the BSP for Linux, which is based on the STM32 OpenST Linux, and for the M4 you can reuse the STM32 MPU package, which is really interesting when you want to use the M4 processor. And so when you want to do project for industrial real-time application like automation for automotive or any industrial field, this processor is really interesting.
And by being at in France, at the French office, you also close by the ST, working collaborating
with them? Yes, we have a really good partnership because we can speak the same language, and they have a really good support for, and so we are working together for the success of our customer project.
And what would you say about the STM32MP1? It's kind of new, but it came out like last year?
Yeah, it came out last year, of course, in the last Embedded World, we had the first chip, and it was a mass market, and now we are in the step of having many customers for it. So we can now say to our customer, hey, don't, we can help you start your project, you can buy our kit and try every possibilities of this kit, and we can help them because we have a support, hardware or software support, and yeah, we can do custom.
Many different ideas around the STM32MP1.
Yeah.
How about updates? Course. Did ST provide some updates since last year?
Yes, they provide updates continuously, and Phytek always keeps this, takes this update, so we are always in line with their software, and also of course the hardware. We always take the last touch chip, and so yeah, for the project starting, our kit is I think a good step to start.